Sometimes you may require to move text inside a table that you have already written, but decided later that it should be inside the table. So, in this video, we will learn that how you can convert that already written text into a table without actually moving it by cut and paste. In this document, I have some piece of information already written that I want to convert into a table. Before we do this, let's clarify some information first. The first thing you should aware of that, how the text has been separated. Converting text to table work best if a text has been consistently separated. To understand this, let's first turn on Show Hide Paragraph Mark option from the Home tab. As you can see in this document, where I have item names on one side and their prices on the other, and both has been separated using tab key, and that tab key is the separator in this text. As you can see in the ruler that I have assigned a left tab to move the cursor exactly below to 4 inch, in a single tab press. Whereas on the second page of the same document, you can see that I have used many tabs to separate text to a specific position on the page. So how this will affect the conversion? We will talk about this later in this video. Let's convert the above text first. You can find Convert Text to Table command under Insert tab, then in Insert drop-down menu. But as you can see that this command is currently unavailable. To convert text into table, first you need to highlight the text that you want to convert. Now click on Insert tab, then click Insert drop-down menu, and then click Convert Text to Table. The Convert Text to Table dialog box appears with some predefined settings. The first thing you should note here is the separate text at, where tab is already selected, and within from the entire selected text, Word has automatically counted that how many columns should be used during conversion, which in our case is 2. Word check the mode of the written text, like how many paragraph marks has been used between words, and which paragraph mark has been used to separate text. If your text has consistency, then Word will automatically suggest you the number of columns required and the paragraph mark used to separate text. On the other hand, if I do the same for the text on the second page, then you can see that Word has automatically grasped the correct paragraph mark, but this time it is showing a total of 7 columns required to separate the text. This is because Word counted the maximum and similar paragraph marks used in the selected text. So, how we can correct this? We will come to this later. Let's first convert the previous text. One more thing that you can notice while converting text to table is number of rows, which in our case are 10. The total selected text actually has a total of 10 lines separated by enter in the end of each line. So, this is how Word identify your text by paragraph marks. The next option you have is auto fit behavior that we have already discussed in our previous video about creating tables in Word. You can either choose fixed column width, which is set to auto, so Word will automatically try to fit the text within columns, or you can go for auto fit according to text, and wrap the text if that doesn't fit within column, or auto fit to window size. If you think that Word has by mistakenly identified the wrong paragraph mark, then you can choose the correct paragraph mark that you have used to separate the text, or if you have used a custom paragraph mark like hyphen or asterisk sign to separate the text, then you can type it in the other box. Once you are done with the settings, click the OK button, and there you have the entire selected text converted into a table. You can adjust the column width if required. Now let's move to the second page, where the tab paragraph mark has been used to separate text, but the problem is that it has been used more than one time in a single line, so Word counted a wrong number of columns, which we don't want. You can also note that if I reduce the column numbers, then number of rows are automatically increasing, and if I go with this setting, see what happened? So the only way to overcome from this problem is to only use a single paragraph mark between text to separate them, and delete the remaining from all the lines. Convert the same text to table again, and you will see that, this time Word has correctly counted the columns. So this is how you can easily convert text to columns. If you found this video useful, then don't forget to share it with your friends. Subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and have a nice day.